Alright guys, so how many of you have done the homework? Or at least attempted it. I don't care whether it is, attempted as in have you attempted more than 30 questions? More than 20? Okay, fine. See, the assignment was meant for you to actually struggle a little bit so that you again refer back to the notes, and then during that process of struggling with the question you will learn a lot of things. So those who have actually attempted the entire assignment, do you think that you have learned something?
Yes.
Right? So now that learning will stay with you. Okay? So it is very easy to ignore, make fun of it, or make fun of people who have done the assignment. It is very easy to do that. Okay? It doesn't take a genius to make fun of anything. Alright? In fact, it takes a fool to make a fun of something or somebody who is working hard. Okay? So you can afford to do that right now, but you will slowly understand that as you progress into the next grade. You know, I have seen many times people who are in class 11th and 12th, they are not able to solve the simplest of the questions. Okay? Why that happens? Because they have ignored the learning in 9th and 10th. Okay? I am not saying that you will not get marks. Okay? Getting marks in 9th and 10th, it is very easy. Because these kind of questions which I have given you will not be asked in the exam as such. Okay? But I am preparing you for the competition to come in 11th and 12th. Alright? So take it seriously for your own sake. If you do a little bit hard work right now, you will save a lot of hard work. I mean, you will not have to do extreme hard work in 11th and 12th. It will be very easy going for you. Getting it? If you do not do a lot of hard work now, by the time you go to 11th, you will see that many of your peers have gone ahead. And then you will tend to give up, that you don't have time or you will be getting frustrated. Alright? So, again, one more thing I wanted to tell you is that, you know, till now we are in a mode of always scoring above 90%, okay, or at least above 80%, isn't it? So, we tend to expect that whatever I do, I should get more than 90% or 80%, whatever I do, alright? But do you guys know that, like for example, JEE Mains results have come, people who score 50 to 60% marks, their ranks are around 4 to 5,000 out of 20 lakh. Okay? There, and those people who are scoring 80% in JEE Advanced, they are topping the exam. They are already rank 1. Alright? And if you are scoring 60% in JEE Advanced, you will be probably 2,000 or 1,000 rank, you will be getting into the IITs. Fine? So why I am telling you all of this is that, you know, at times in a pressure of getting everything correct, whatever I do, you tend to ignore the kind of learning you will be having. Fine? So, do not pressurize yourself that I should get each and every question right, and if I am not getting right, then something is wrong with me, and you start getting, lot of pressure will pile up in you. So, do not pressurize yourself. So, what I told when I given you assignment, attempt it. Did I say that you should get all of it right? No. I was not expecting that any of you will get, you know, even 60-70% also right. Fine, because this is the first time you are attempting something which is slightly indirect. Till now we are used to of having questions like, you know, that for example, distance is 2 meter, time taken is 1 second, what is the speed? You know, something like this. Do you think it is fun to learn all of that? I mean, there is nothing to learn first of all. Right? Just a formula substitution. And do you think you will learn anything solving those kind of questions, hundreds and terms of those type of questions? You will not learn anything. Fine? So that is why expose yourself to these kind of questions. It will really make a difference. Maybe not now, but definitely when you go to higher standards, you will be far ahead of your peers. Okay, and you will be a lot more relaxed also later on, because you have already learned the tricks, whatever it takes. Fine. So again, I'm repeating: do not pressurize yourself with that. You know, you'll be getting everything correct, and if you're not understanding, if you're not able to solve a particular question, something is wrong. You know, you start putting a lot of pressure. You start getting frustrated. Need not be. Okay, these questions are not meant to be, you know, solved completely 100%. Nobody will be able to do it at your stage. Fine. All right. So I will continue with this chapter. Okay. So last class we had some quiz sort of thing, right? So all Chotus, Pintos, or what is that? So all of them are sitting together, or they are mixed up now? They are mixed up. Okay. Anyways, so today's class we'll be solving numericals. Fine. We'll be solving numericals, and we'll be taking some standard theoretical questions that can be asked in your school exams. Okay. So since we are taking numericals, we'll be taking it gradually from the base level. We'll go up to the high level questions. Fine. So before we even start that, okay, before we even start solving numericals. So what I was saying here, before we even start solving numericals, let us first understand what kind of numericals can be asked, what all things can be asked. Fine. Well, what do you think can be asked in a particular numerical? What do you think? They'll be asking you to calculate what? You may be asked to calculate. Okay, somebody said speed. Speed can be asked to calculate. What else? Distance may be asked. What else?
Time
may be asked. Then acceleration may be asked.
Velocity.
What else? Displacement may be asked. Then what else? What else would be asked? Anything else? Deceleration is opposite of acceleration. It's same. What else could be asked? What do you think? Mass? No. In this chapter, in the motion, mass has nothing to do with it. Because mass represents, you know, resistance against uniform motion or state of rest. So you are getting to the cause of the motion. This chapter doesn't deal with what is causing the motion. Height can be asked. Height, don't you think it will be either distance or displacement? Okay, but this is very important. The way he said, height may be asked. Now, in that question, it will not be directly written, find out the displacement or find the distance. You have to understand that height could be the displacement. Are you getting it? So you have to make sense of the story. The questions may not be directly like this, that distance is this, time is this, 500 the velocity. They'll be asking you something like this, you know, Ram is standing on a floor, he throws a ball with a velocity, and then after some time it has landed on the ground. So something like this might be there. Alright? So you have to find out what is the velocity, what is the distance, what is the time in that story. Yes or no? Right? So when you solve a numerical, what do you think your first step should be? When you look at, when you read the story, what do you think the first step should be? Correct. So first step between you solving a numerical and reading a question is what? You write down whatever variables are given. Where are the variables? Only these are the variables. Yes or no? These are the variables. So you clearly write down. When you read a question, you write, okay, fine. Velocity is given. Time is given. Okay. And maybe displacement is asked. Like this you write in every numerical. Getting it? Right? So when you write down like this, then you move on to the next step. Alright? Do not just read the particular question and straight away jump into the problem solving. Getting it? Alright? So this is very important step. Now, these are the things that could be asked in a particular numerical. Is there anything else, do you think? No. Right? Now, these are things to be calculated. What are things you have in hand? Like, what are tools you have to calculate these? You have formulas or equations? Yes or no? Can you tell me what are the equations you have so that you can relate these variables and get the answer? Tell me the first formula, very easy one. Okay, that is equation of motion. Okay, the equation of motion is valid when there is a constant acceleration.
Yeah.
Yes or no? But before we even get into the equations of motion, can we have any other equation? What? A is equal to? Okay, so first formula, what is her name? Sharda. Sharduli. Okay, Sharduli has told us average acceleration formula. What is the average acceleration? Final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. Delta t. Whatever delta t is there between initial and final velocity. This is the average velocity formula. Okay? And when you write down like this, you are assuming that, first of all, when you write value of v and u, you are writing it as a number. You are writing 4 or 5 like this. Okay? So you are assuming it that the object is moving in a straight line. Write this down. The motion in a straight line only, this is true. Yes or no? Only when object is moving in a straight line. Otherwise also this formula is true. But then you can't treat them like numbers. You have to take the direction also in account. That is not in your syllabus right now. Okay? We have only motion in a straight line in our syllabus. Okay? Now tell me, if object is going, let's say, towards a north direction with a velocity of 2 meter per second. Okay? So it is going towards a north direction with a velocity of 2 meter per second. Okay? After 2 seconds, its velocity becomes towards the south, 2 meter per second. It took 2 seconds. Okay? Can you tell me what is the average acceleration? What it is? Is it 0?
Yeah.
All of you agree it is 0?
Yeah.
Anybody else? The answer is not 0. It will be?
Minus. Yeah.
Okay, now here something very important is coming up. Okay? You have to assume one direction to be positive, the other direction becomes negative. Write it down again, you have not remembered it. Write it down. In this entire chapter, okay, these things which have direction, you know, for example, acceleration has a direction sense, velocity has a direction sense, and displacement has a direction sense. Yes or no? So these three things, whenever you write their values, you have to assume one direction to be positive, the other direction will become negative. Fine? So if you say that north direction is positive, let's say if you say north is my positive direction, okay? So the final velocity is what? Plus 2 or minus 2? Minus 2, right? North is positive. You are assuming north to be positive. You can say north is negative also. Then the final velocity is plus 2. But you are saying north is positive, so final velocity is minus 2. Fine. Initial velocity is plus 2 or minus 2?
Plus 2.
So V minus U becomes how much? Minus 2 minus of 2. See, this is the final velocity and this is the initial velocity. Yes or no? Minus 2 minus of 2. Final velocity is minus 2. Initial velocity is 2. This divided by delta t, which is 2. So you are getting it as minus 2 meters per second square. Fine. So throughout the chapter, remember this, that one direction you have to take positive, the other direction will become negative. This is very important. Okay. Can I move this up? Not possible. See, there used to be hand symbol also, right?
Sir,
okay, fine. So this is the average acceleration formula. What else? What do you think could be the next formula that you will be asked to use? Average
velocity.
Average velocity. What is average velocity? Average velocity is total displacement. By whatever time it has taken, total time. Right? Okay, let's do a numerical here. This tower of height, let us say h. Fine. So you have thrown a ball upwards, okay, and it has landed on the ground after time delta t. Fine. It went up and came down in a time of delta t. Alright, you have to tell me what is the average velocity. At the first tell me which direction you are taking positive?
Upward
direction. Upward direction positive? Upward is positive. Okay, now tell me how much is the displacement?
Minus h.
Minus h? Minus h, it is going down. It is going up also, but displacement is what? Shortest distance between the two locations, location 1, location 2, initial and final location. Displacement is down, minus h, and time taken is delta t. So average velocity is minus h by delta t. Simple. Okay, and then you have to write in the bracket also that considering upward direction to be positive. Okay, if you consider downward to be positive, your average velocity will be h by delta t. Fine. Okay, can I give you another question? Okay, here is the question. The total distance is d. Okay, the object covers, this is a straight line, okay? The object covers half the distance with velocity v1 and other half with a velocity of v2. Fine, this is d by 2. This is also d by 2. Alright, you have to find what is the average velocity over here. Okay. Anyone got it? only one person has got Sharduli. Ajay, guys, have you been attempting the question today? I don't think many of the Kormagla guys made there. Most of them are from Rajaji Nagar and HSR and INR. Okay. How many of you solved this? Only one? You got it? See, it is a direct formula substitution. Delta T is not given key. See, total time is not given. Okay, what is given is half the distance is covered with the velocity of V1, other half is covered with V2.
The correct one right at the first go because you're learning, alright?
So if you are not doing anything which is not proper, you will get the right answer. Fine. So suppose you are using this equation to find the displacement and then substituting here to get the time. Fine. You could have used this one directly. But even if you are using indirectly, you will get the same answer. Fine. So do not hesitate to use a particular equation. Okay. And in these three equations, you have all the variables which have direction sense except time. Alright? So in all these equations, before you even apply these three equations, first thing you have to do what? Assume one direction positive, the other direction becomes negative. That you must follow. Fine? So for example, you know, acceleration could be in this direction, initial velocity in opposite direction. Okay, so if you are taking initial velocity direction to be positive, acceleration becomes negative. Then that acceleration is deceleration actually. Fine, deceleration is nothing but acceleration in the opposite direction of initial velocity, nothing else. Fine, you could have assumed the acceleration direction positive, then your initial velocity direction becomes negative. So things are very straightforward. Keep it like that. Okay, so now after we learned these equations, then what we did? We have considered the motion under the gravity. Yes or no? What is it? Alright, so after this we have considered the case of motion under gravity. What kind of motion we have considered under the gravity? Straight line motion. Can there be any other motion other than straight line motion under gravity? If I throw this pen like this, will it move in a straight line? No, it will take a curved path. Yes or no? So we are not learning that in 9th. Fine. We are learning the motion only when you throw up, down, or just drop it. Getting it? So motion in the straight line in the gravity case happens when you write it down. Under gravity, motion in straight line, under gravity, motion in straight line will happen when the initial velocity is upwards or downwards or equal to zero. Got it? It is common sense, isn't it? We have experienced it. So you don't need to be told as such. Just that I'm making you recollect that. Okay? Mathematically you should understand that if initial velocity is zero, it will just go straight down. Yes or no? If you throw up, it will go up and then come down. If you throw it down vertically, it will go down. Fine? And what else? In the motion under gravity, what is the special condition?
Acceleration.
There is an acceleration which is acceleration due to gravity, whose value is 9.8. Fine? There will always be an acceleration vertically down. There should not be any confusion. If object is in air near the earth surface, its acceleration is 9.8 down. Okay? At times in the question it will be written, for the sake of simplicity of the calculation, they write assume g to be 10. Fine? Okay? So acceleration is always down. Alright? So the downward acceleration is 9.8 meter per second square. So we tend to always assume upward direction to be positive. It need not be. But if you assume upward direction to be positive, acceleration will be always minus 9.8. If you assume upward to be positive, acceleration is always minus 9.8. Getting it? Any doubt? No doubt? Alright. So, now we will be making use of these equations. See, you have just these 5 equations. Alright? There is nothing else. See how simple things are. You have to use these equations. Assume one direction positive, other direction become negative. That's it. And find these variables. What will stop you to solve a question is not using these equations. What will stop you is when you read a question, how to write, what variables are given and what to find. Are you getting it? These equations will not stop you. Once you know what is initial velocity, what is time and what is displacement, do you think there is any brainer in applying these equations? No. What will stop you is understanding the question and writing the variables. Fine? So when that will go away, when you practice a lot of questions yourself. Alright? Practicing just using this equation will not help you. Fine? So, any doubts in whatever revision we have done for this chapter? Any doubts? No doubts? Nothing? Alright.
What about the equation P is equal to O over QH by T?
That is not an equation, but that was a numerical. You have remembered the final expression for that numerical. You should not. So the way I teach is that you should not remember other than the basic things. You will be solving millions of numericals, millions of different types of scenarios. You can't remember each and every final expression. Okay? But it is good to remember. That is also correct. But the problem is that you get confused. If you remember a lot of such equations, it may not be true for some scenario. Then you may apply the wrong equation. But these equations are always true. Fine? Any other doubt? Anything else? Ask doubt. No doubt. No doubt. Okay. Other than these, what else we have learned? Do you remember anything else? Graphs. We have learned about graphs. We have spent 3-4 hours just learning the graphs. So remember that. Okay? What are kinds of graphs we have learned? We have learned displacement time graph. Okay? Then velocity time graph. For different kinds of scenario. Yes or no? Okay? Now let us try to revise everything. Then we can get into the problem solving. Suppose this is displacement time graph. Okay. Can you draw a plot when object is at rest? Object doesn't move. Will it be a horizontal line? Why horizontal line? Because its position is not changing with over a period of time. If its position is at x equal to 5 meter, it remains x equal to 5 meter. Okay? So any horizontal line you draw represents the object at rest. Getting it? Okay? What about an object moving with constant velocity? It will have some angle with the x-axis. Yes or no? Okay, now tell me what is the difference between these two graphs. What?
So one is not parallel to the
other. Where I have drawn? Aja, you have learned. Not that. This line and you already started answering and this one. Between red, between yellow and green, what is the difference? He is saying yellow is acceleration, is it true?
Yes.
That is not true. So you can see that in yellow line, x is increasing with time. X is increasing in time or not?
Yes.
And in green, x is decreasing with time. So if one is moving in positive direction, the other goes in the opposite direction. Fine? The yellow and green lines, they represent motion in opposite directions. That's it. Getting it? Any doubt? Fine? So if, or you can, you know, say it like this, if this angle with x axis, this is less than 90 degree. If the angle is less than 90 degree, it is moving in positive direction. If the angle is more than 90 degree, which is this one, this green line makes more than 90 degree angles, then it is not deceleration, moving in negative direction. Both are having equation 0. Fine? So at times you can see the graph and find out what is going on. Getting it? Now if I tell you that this is the graph, can you tell me what is the velocity? This is x and this is t. Can you tell me a method to find the velocity using this graph? All of you, try solving this. Can you tell me a method? First of all, is it a uniform velocity or not? It is a uniform velocity, right? So can you tell me a method to find the velocity?
The
area
of the triangle.
No. Achha, you tell me one more thing. If it is a uniform velocity, the average velocity between any two points will be same or not? It will be same. I can take any two points, the average velocity between any two points will be same. Write it down, please write down. If an object is traveling, If an object is traveling with uniform velocity, then the average velocity between any two points will be same. Okay. Between any two points, the average velocity will be same. So this is the hint also. Can you tell me how will you get the value of average velocity using the graph? Think over it. You don't have to immediately answer. Think over it. Straight line. you take any two points, it will be coming out to be same. Okay? Any doubts? Huh?
In the second time, what the time?
Like, time is this distance, this length, this much length.
Time can go to negative.
Delta t cannot be negative. Time can go to negative. Suppose I say t equal to 0 right now. So whatever I have done before t equal to 0 is negative time. Okay? But time will always move forward. Change in time can never be negative. Getting it? Fine. So remember, you can do various things with the xt graph. Any doubt with xt graph? Alright, can you plot, guys, listen, can you plot constant acceleration graph for xt? Do it, all of you please attempt it. We have done all of this, last class and last class we have attempted everything. Good. Constant acceleration, you take any acceleration, the pattern of the curve will not be different, it will be same. Good. Okay, so all of you getting it? XT graph, XT, not VT.
So what is X?
X is the location, position. This is not possible. Why? Okay, so some of you have drawn like this, okay, some of you have drawn like this, and maybe because of some error or not very careful, some of you have drawn like this. Okay, oh, what is wrong with the third one? You're traveling back in time. Okay, so this is, it's just a casual error. Okay. Alright, what is the difference between these two? This one starts from x equal to 0, this one starts from x equal to whatever it is. Okay, x greater than 0. Fine. Now tell me, what is the difference between this one and this one? Acceleration of this one is more. Okay. Right. So you can look at the graph. You can make out various things. All right. Now, what do you think this is?
Acceleration.
Is it acceleration initially and then deceleration?
So it's traveling with velocity, but then it's deceleration slowly as you're talking.
Is it acceleration or deceleration or combination of both?
Total is deceleration.
So deceleration.
What is it?
It's only deceleration.
It is only deceleration. It's only deceleration. Okay? If it is downward opening curve, it is only deceleration. What is happening is that initial velocity is very high. Then you can see that velocity is what? The how steep the curve is, right? You can see the steepness is decreasing. And then steepness is increasing in opposite direction. Is velocity becoming zero somewhere?
Yes.
At the topmost point, the velocity is becoming zero. From that point onwards, the velocity is changing its direction. Yes or no? Okay, so graph will tell you many things. You can just look at the graph carefully, you can understand what is going on. Okay, so this is XT graph that we have learned last class. Okay, what about VT graph? Can you plot a graph for object at rest? Can you be a dot? It will line on the x-axis, velocity is 0, right? So the x-axis itself is v is equal to 0. Yes or no? So a line along the x-axis represents v is equal to 0 because v is on the y-axis. What does this line represent?
Constant
velocity. If this represents maybe 2 meter per second, this will represent 0 meter per second, which is at rest. Okay, now tell me the plot for constant acceleration. Straight line?
No, it's a horizontal
line. Horizontal line. Will it be like this? Is this acceleration?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, you can imagine, you know, you can first ask yourself, if something is accelerating, velocity will change or not?
Yes.
Velocity cannot remain constant.
Yes.
Okay, and the way you're saying acceleration, probably you mean that velocities should increase. Okay, so velocity should increase with time. So this represents increase of velocity or not?
Yes.
Right, now what is this? This is acceleration in opposite direction of initial velocity. Velocity will decrease with time. This is deceleration also. People say that this is deceleration. There is another name to negative acceleration. Okay? So, this just represents acceleration which is opposite direction of the initial velocity. So, its velocity should decrease with time. Yes or no? All of you agree? Any doubt? Now tell me, what is this? Then why is it going below? Is the direction of velocity changing or not?
Yes.
Can you tell me an example when that this happens?
Displacement is reverse.
Give me a simpler example.
So when you throw a ball up.
Wait. Kya beta? When you throw a ball up, acceleration is in which direction? Downwards. So its velocity decreases, becomes 0 at the topmost position. Right? And then its direction of velocity reverses, it comes down. Yes or no? So this is that graph. So you know, at times we look at the graph, we tend to think that graph represent the path of the object, but it is not the path. Okay?
So when the ball is coming down, what's the acceleration?
It's in the opposite direction.
No, wait. This is an important doubt, guys. Wait. See, when you're throwing ball up, till the ball is coming to rest, what's the joke going on? Come here and share with everyone. Okay, so next time you cry a joke in the middle of the class, I'll ask you to come here and share it with everyone. And we'll record also. It will be probably a good joke. Anyways, so if you throw a ball up, initial velocity is upward, acceleration is downwards, right? So velocity will decrease both in opposite direction, and we are assuming downward to be negative. Remember this, downward is negative, so velocity is decreasing, and at the topmost position becomes 0. And then after that, velocity will also become negative downwards. That is what is happening here. Negative velocity, and that negative velocity will keep on increasing till it hits the ground. That is what it is. Make sense? Alright, so this plot, the pink line, represents the change, there is a direction change of the velocity. Here it is positive velocity, this is negative velocity. Okay, such things do exist. Okay, so graph can tell you with, you know, various aspects of it. Now tell me, what is this? One more graph I plot. This one. What kind of graph? What is happening here?
Deceleration.
So it's like a ball bouncing.
Is it like
ball bouncing? Again, you are thinking that it is a path of the object. It is not a path.
So it's like when a car is going to stop, and then that's it.
Correct. I mean, in a way, it is correct, but you can see that instantaneously, you know, there is a change in the direction of acceleration. Yes or no, Centum? This is deceleration. From this point to this point, is deceleration or not? Velocity is decreasing, and then from here to there, it is acceleration. The object comes to rest or not? Before, from deceleration to acceleration, object comes to rest. It could be like this also. Then what is this? Before coming to rest, the acceleration has changed the direction. Okay, let me explain it again. Okay guys, focus here. This is point A. All of you please draw this. A, B, C. A, B, and C. If you forget about B to C, just look at A to B. What it is? Deceleration. Write down A to B is deceleration. A to B, deceleration. B to C, acceleration. Okay, so object has initial velocity. Before there was a deceleration, it had some velocity. Then object decelerated, stop. Write down, object decelerated, stop, and then starts moving with acceleration. Does this completely describe the scenario?
Yeah. So,
that's what I'm saying, deceleration then acceleration. It means change in direction. Getting it? Any doubt? No doubt? Okay, now tell me what is going on here. All of you focus here. What is this? What is going on? Wait. Let me mark.